In this video, I will demonstrate how to use leap motion's grasp detectors. Grasp detectors allow us to monitor a group of interactable objects and perform an action when one of those objects are grabbed. Here, I have three pickups with different colors. For the moment, I want to code some functionality so that whenever I grasp any one of these pickups, a sphere will fall from the sky. To add this functionality, I'll first create an empty game object called sphere generator. This game object is responsible for instantiating spheres in the sky. I've also already created a script called sphere generator and attached it to the object. Here's what the script looks like. This script has one function called create falling sphere. This function will create a sphere in the sky, then add a rigid body to that sphere so that it falls down. Now that our generator is set up, we'll need a way to call the create falling sphere function when we grab any of these pickups. I'll create an empty game object called object watcher. This object has the responsibility of monitoring the pickups and performing actions when one of the pickups is grasped. Leap Motion's interaction grasp detector script does the monitoring for us. Let's add the script to the object watcher. In the inspector, you'll see onActivate and onDeactivate Unity events under the interaction grasp detector component. These function similarly to onGraspBegin and onGraspEnd from the interaction grasp event script in the last video. When an object we are monitoring is grabbed, onActivate is called. When an object we are monitoring is released, onDeactivate is called. In onActivate Uni event, I'll call the createFallingSphere method from the sphere generator script of the sphere generator object. I'll set handModel to brushHandR and checkmark the Any Interaction Object option under the section Detector Targets. This means that onActivate will only work when our hand picks up any interaction object, not our left hand. Let's try it out. Both hands have to be in the scene for this to work. That is, both hands have to be detected. Otherwise, some unintended actions may occur. As you can see, only the right hand will create a sphere, not the left hand. Now, let's switch it out with the left hand. Now, what if we want to create falling spheres only when the purple or green objects are picked up? Under Detector Targets, we can uncheck the Any Interaction Object option and click the drop-down beside Target Object. Here, we can specify which objects to monitor. I'll input a size of 2, press Enter, then add only the purple and green pickups. I'll also switch back to the right hand, as that is my dominant hand. Look at that. Only the green and purple pickups created the spheres. Now the last option under detector targets is the tag name option. Before I show how this works, let's set the target object size back to 0. When we specify a tag name, only objects which are tagged with that name will create the following sphere. Let's set the tag name field to pickups and tag our purple and blue pickups as pickups. As you can see, everything worked as expected.